this.
Dr. Healy's a surgeon, Mr. President. Other members of the White House Science Council.
Hi, how are you?
Look this way, sir. Excellent.
Well, thank you very much. I shall look forward to it.
Dr. Telster, President.
President Bill Fisher. Hello, sir. Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
Charles Reagan.
Thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you.
President. Saul Buxbaum, Chairman of the White House Science Council.
It's a pleasure serving you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Professor Singer, MIT.
See you again.
Thank you. See you.
Bill Hamilton from Duke.
Hello.
I have a new shirt for you. Duke University.
Well, thank you.
Ed Freeman from San Diego, Mr. President.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Sandy McDonald.
Well done, Mr. President.
Well, thank you. Nice to see you.
Very good. Joe DeSutter, Secretary of the President.
Good to see you.
Yeah. And if everyone could just tighten up as much as you can on either side.
Yes, yes it is. That's the sprint. To keep it from maybe curling over a little bit. And maybe like a cannon wire. I couldn't get any comment there.
Okay, great. Everybody can look right here. Big smiles. Thank you, Mr. President.
Ladies and gentlemen, of science, be interested in knowing that operation for the Dupuytren contraction just from here up to here took 2.5 hours. I couldn't believe it. I went into the hospital with a picture that I'd be sitting on the corner of a desk or a chair with a flannel shirt and a pair of slacks and watch them work on that for a few minutes and get up and walk out. No, I was stretched out in a green hospital suit. I couldn't see it. They put something in here and deadened my arm.
They didn't trust you, huh?
And I stayed there and I stayed there, and then the horrifying thing, I heard one of the doctors say, well, it'll be just about another hour. But it seems that there's a lot of little nerves in the hand there, and that's what it was.
Operations in the hand are more difficult than the brain.
Yes. And as, well, as a matter of fact, he probably knows that the history that after World War I, there was a great neglect of hand wounds because of more serious wounds that they thought were life-saving and so forth. And then the record as it developed of hand wounds and hand injuries and so forth led the Army then to set up and declare they were going to become specialists in hand surgery and those problems. And I don't think there's any higher level today than there is there at the Army, like at Walter Reed Hospital, on that particular subject.
So, were they Republicans?
What?
Were they Republicans?
I asked the doctors to took care of me when I was shot. I decided that these military gentlemen, maybe I'd just take it for granted. Yes. Well, you didn't come here to ask, have me tell you about my operation. But I do want to thank all of you.
Well, Mr. President, as chairman of the council, I assure you, sir, that it was a pleasure that we to work with you and with Dr. Gray. It's that's almost 8 years.
Well, I thank all of you for the service that you've rendered.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you very much, sir. The best of everything.
Well, thank you. I was in terms about I'm retiring. I'm switching jobs.
Great speaking.
So thank you. Thank you very much.
Excellent. Thanks for the good to be with us. Any message you want to give?
Yeah, just give it on my table.
Just give it on one politician to another.